We always love simple answers to difficult questions. For providing simple answers to difficult questions in the making of chemical molecules, Nobel Prize in Chemistry 2022 was awarded to three great scientists: Barry Sharpless of Scripps Research, USA, Carolyn Bertozzi of Stanford University, USA, and Morten Meldal of University of Copenhagen, Denmark, for the development of click chemistry and bioorthogonal chemistry. This video is a humble attempt to explain great work of these great scientists. Let's begin with a brief introduction of click chemistry. Why we need click chemistry and what is the significance of click chemistry? Chemists are often amazed with the complexity and diversity of chemical molecules present in plants, animals, and microorganisms. Many chemists imitated nature or natural molecules for artificially synthesizing these important chemicals. But there is a big difficulty in making complex biomolecules. In nature, biomolecules are produced just like this, starting with a reactant, then a sequential reactions forming many intermediates and finally forming the product with many byproducts. In a biological system, all these intermediates are used up, maybe used in different chemical reactions, byproducts are also used up. When we imitate the same thing in an artificial system, a synthetic system, we end up in having many unwanted intermediate products and also byproducts of no use. That makes the process more expensive, less efficient, and extremely difficult. A great alternative was put forward by these three scientists, and that is click chemistry. So this is a beautiful figure that highlights how click chemistry works. So chemicals are clicked together to form new molecules. In click chemistry, suppose this is reagent 1 and this is reagent 2. We are clicking it together or joining it together, forming a product. The advantage is there are no intermediates, no byproducts, a very simple reaction. That is why this is called as click chemistry, an easy way to make chemical molecules. It is just like this Lego building blocks. We can have different combinations of chemicals, we can combine it to make different molecules. Now let us see why these scientists were awarded with Nobel Prize, a summary of their contributions. First one is Barry Sharpless. He pioneered the concept of click chemistry, a form of simple and reliable chemistry where reactions occur quickly and efficiently without any unwanted products. And the second one is Morten Meldal. He presented the crown jewel of click chemistry, the copper-catalyzed azide-alkyne cycloaddition, a chemical reaction that is utilized in the development of pharmaceuticals for mapping DNA and for the making of n number of chemicals. And finally, Carolyn Bertozzi has given a different dimension to this click reaction. She developed click reactions that works inside biological system. Her bioorthogonal reactions takes place without disrupting the normal chemistry of the cell that is now used globally to explore cells to track biological processes. Now let us see in detail the works of each of these great scientists, starting with Barry Sharpless. At that time, as we mentioned earlier, chemists were imitating natural molecules for synthesizing that in the lab, following the reactions of nature. But as we said, very difficult to produce large scale. Take the case of meropenem antibiotic. It took nearly 6 years for large scale industrial production after many chemical modifications. So imitating natural molecules is an expensive, inefficient, very difficult process. So Barry Sharpless put forward the idea of click chemistry. In biomolecules, there are bonds between carbon atoms. In a synthetic system, these carbon atoms lack the chemical drive to form bonds with each other. So we need to activate it artificially. This artificial activation leads to numerous unwanted side reactions and a costly loss of material. And he suggested a different method, which is called as click chemistry. Use small molecules with a complete carbon frame and link it together using bridges of nitrogen and oxygen, which is comparatively easily controllable. So simply combining, simple molecules can be combined together or clicking together, joining together, forms the click chemistry. Let me give an example. In his paper, he listed that for a chemical reaction to be called click chemistry, it should occur in the presence of oxygen and water. As we know, water is an universal solvent and oxygen both are very cheap and environment friendly. So this is a green chemistry with huge potential. So Barry Sharpless pioneered the concept of click chemistry. He even coined the term click chemistry. Now the contribution of Morten Meldal. He was actually developing methods for finding potential pharmaceutical substances to stop pathological processes. He was working with chemicals to stop pathological infections. Once he conducted a routine reaction, he wanted to react this acyl halide with alkyne in the presence of copper and palladium as catalyst. So this is a normal reaction. In the reaction, there was an unexpected twist. He thought that the halide end of this acyl halide will react with alkyne. But what happened is this azide end of this acyl halide reacted with alkyne and triazole is formed. As we all know, triazole is a versatile chemical that has many applications in pharmaceuticals as antifungal agent, antibacterial agent, the making of dyes in agriculture as fungicides, then building blocks of many chemicals. Previously, a series of reaction, a very difficult process is needed to make this triazole a stable building block chemical for synthesizing many other chemicals. So he found out a simple method for making triazole and also the click reaction that changed chemistry. Now any chemist can combine two molecules by simply adding azide to one molecule and alkyne to other molecule, and both molecules will be joined by triazole. Just like a click, snapping together molecules very efficiently without any unwanted product, byproduct or intermediates. He published the paper. Meantime, Sharpless also published the same concept, copper catalyzed azide-alkyne cycloaddition. So click reaction is a simple chemical reaction for making molecules. And finally, the contribution of Carolyn Bertozzi. She was working on mapping of genes and proteins to understand how cells works. Her focus was on glycans, a complex carbohydrates present on cell surface. First, what she intended was to find out a molecular handle to attach fluorescent label. She used many chemicals. At the end, she ended up using azide. She fed cells with a modified sugar with an azide on it. The azide functioned as a typical molecular handle. The modified sugar that is incorporated into the glycans of the cell surface. Thus, azide become a successful molecular handle. Then she attached fluorescent label to this azide to track glycans inside the cell. But there were many limitations. Meanwhile, she heard about this click chemistry. And she know that azide is used, so there is a chance of making it more stable by applying click chemistry. But there are some difficulties. Firstly, the reaction between handle and fluorescent molecule had to be bioorthogonal. That means the reaction would not interfere with the normal biological process of the cell. Copper ions are required for click reaction. Copper ions are toxic to cells. So it is not bioorthogonal. It cannot be used. Then she had an extensive literature study and she found a paper, 1961, a paper in which describing alkyne can be forced into a ring-shaped molecule, then it can be easily combined with azide. A strain-promoted, copper-independent, alkyne-azide cycloaddition, she developed a technique, then clicked reaction. Alkyne with fluorescent green molecule combined with azide forming a triazole with this fluorescent green molecule. So that allowed Bertozzi to track glycans on the cell surface. So this is the result. As you see, Bertozzi used strain promoted click reaction to track glycans. This green colored is the glycans as it is fluorescently labeled, whereas this blue color is the cell nucleus. So she developed a technique, a click reaction, that is independent of copper, which can be effectively used inside a biological system without any toxic effects, unwanted effects, a strain-promoted alkyne-azide cycloaddition. She made clickable antibodies. As you see, in the case of tumor cells, these tumor cells are masked by these glycans on the surface, so immune cells cannot detect these tumor cells. So she made an antibody, a clickable antibody, that is bonded with an enzyme by click reaction. So the specific antibody that is targeted against tumor that binds to a tumor cell, and this enzyme will degrade these glycans. So unmasked cancer cell that can be easily detected by the immune cells, and these cells will be cleared out. And these clickable antibodies are now in the clinical trials. Carolyn Bertozzi's contribution helped scientists across the globe to map genes and proteins to track biological processes efficiently using this click chemistry. And finally, the applications and future prospects of click chemistry and bioorthogonal chemistry. There are many applications. Click chemistry widely used in the making of chemicals, a simple reaction. Then in the making of dyes in agriculture for making fungicides. There are different applications for click chemistry. A simple method of joining two molecules together without forming any intermediate products or unwanted byproducts. Presently, bioorthogonal chemistry is widely used in cell mapping, tracking biological processes, tracking biomolecules inside the cell. Then clickable antibodies, hopefully targeted tumor treatment, will also be there with the application of bioorthogonal chemistry along with click chemistry. And that is about the Nobel Prize work in chemistry 2022. Thank you so much for your attention. Take care, stay blessed. You are with biologyexamsfory.com.